Welcome to an extra special episode of the Doghouse Connect. Today's episode is hosted by the class of 2018, and we've had a lot happen this past week.
For today's first story, let's hop on over to Gretchen and Audrey, who covered a St. Joseph Elementary tradition in preparation for Toad Suck Days.
The annual Toad Suck Days Festival is a big part of our Conway community.
Each year, St. Joseph Elementary participates in this world championship toad race. This year, there are many students who caught and brought toads from their houses in order to race against the toads of their fellow classmates.
McKenna Lucy was the winner, and she'll be representing St. Joe this weekend at Toad Suck Days.
So wish her and her toad good luck. I'm Audrey.
And I'm Gretchen, and we're with the Doghouse Connect.
Good luck to McKenna at the official toad races. Moving up a few grades, Parker is here to discuss the 8th grade girls' involvement in Girls Power in STEM program.
Last Friday, UCA hosted the Girl Power in STEM event. Girl Power in STEM is a unique opportunity for 8th grade girls to explore career opportunities in science, technology, engineering, and math. Let's go inside and talk to Ms. Perano and see how she feels about this event.
I'm Parker Trussell, sitting here with Kristen Perano, who's going to be taking 8 8th graders to the UCA Girl Power STEM Day. What do we hope to encourage by going to this?
Well, I hope to encourage these girls to kind of develop an understanding of their potential in these STEM fields. So this will kind of encourage them to see the potential value of sticking with and staying and pursuing these fields. I would like for them to get hands-on experiences. I would like for them to learn new things, to meet new friends. What I'm really excited about is I want them to hear from women in those fields that come from similar backgrounds, from similar towns, and really celebrate their success. I want them to, if it's their dream, to kind of visualize what they can become and to pursue those fields.
8th grade is an important time in young girls' lives where they tend to face increased peer expectations that might discourage them from pursuing these fields. Let's go talk to an 8th grader who participated in this event and see how it might have impacted their potential career path.
So it showed me that just because I'm a girl, I can still go into engineering or medical practices. Like, it helped me learn about all different sorts of jobs. Engineers, we learned about the Air Force people, and we learned about doctors, and we got to meet a lot of the people that have those jobs. It was cool, like, seeing that girls can, just from Arkansas, can have such a great impact on the world.
Thank you for telling us a little bit about this event. For those of you who have not quite reached 8th grade, this might be something you want to participate in. It's a great opportunity to get to listen to featured speakers, such as this year's speaker, who is an Arkansas native and also a member of the Navy for 30 years, who helped develop the first computer-generated image of a naval battleship. Thank you for tuning in. This has been Parker Trussell with the Doghouse Connect.
What a great opportunity for young girls in our community to get to learn from such inspiring women. Speaking of great opportunities, the multimedia class got to go to Alice 107.7 this past week. We even got to meet Heather and Pool Boy.
We are here outside of Heather and Pool Boy station, where we are going to get a tour from Pool Boy.
The stuff, or what any of this stuff does, all I know is that I'm not allowed to touch any of here. This is right here, and then here is Alice 107.7. And if you guys want to come on in here, we'll show you what this looks like in here.
So this is where the magic happens.
Up all the way around.
If you want to call it that.
God, there's a bunch of you.
To listen to what they go through on a daily life, we're able to see how they're getting their news coverage, how they're supposed to be able to interact with each other, and just bring a realism to what they do on a day-to-day for their show.
Sadly, I wasn't able to go, but it seems like everyone had a blast. Plus, y'all got to meet some of the local celebrities.
We really did. Now let's turn over to Clayton and Michael, who is covering Ring Day 2018.
The junior class celebrated Ring Day this Wednesday. We got to talk to Alicia Earle, the junior sponsor, to tell us about this time-honored tradition.
Hey, Joseph is one of my very favorite traditions. Symbolically, Ring Day is about the juniors taking the torch of leadership from the seniors. The seniors are passing it off to them. Typically, it's the seniors' very last mass of the year, except for their graduation mass. Ring Day is something that the juniors look forward to from the very beginning of school. And so it starts out with them choosing their class rings just like anybody would. But instead of just slipping the rings on when Jostens brings them in, they go through an actual ceremony. They have a mass. This year we were fortunate that Bishop Taylor was able to be with us and to actually bless the rings and hand each ring to our juniors.
All right, Jacob and Hoff, tell me what you're most excited for senior year.
Well, I'm really excited about having our last year in high school and graduating and parking in the senior parking lot.
Yes, nice. Parking in the senior parking lot is going to be nice. Off-campus lunch, that'll be nice too.
Cutting in front of everybody at lunch.
Hey, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
That's good.
The most important part of Ring Day, though, is the party afterwards. Looks like everyone's having a great time at Ring Day. I know all of you will be great seniors next year. Good luck to the class of 2019. I'm Clayton Heescott, and this has been the Doghouse Connect.
Looks like the juniors had a lot of fun. Sophomores, this is what you have to look forward to next year. Now let's go over to Chloe and Emily to see how the annual Interact Club picnic at Lake Beaverfork went.
The Interact Club has been working hard this year.
To reward them for all their hard work, we are hosting the annual Interact Club picnic.
Come check it out.
Thanks to the Interact Board for hosting a wonderful picnic. Now Ian and Bridget have a small tribute to the class of 2018.
To the class of 2018. For 14 years, we've truly developed into our own little chosen family. They say home is where the heart is, and this compassionately competitive group of students will forever hold a place in mine. Looking towards the future, here's where the class of 2018 plans to take their next steps.
The University of Central Arkansas to study elementary education, STEM education,
political science,
nursing,
computer science,
nursing, radiography,
computer science,
biology pre-dental,
communication and science disorders,
clinical psychology,
nursing,
elementary education,
chemistry,
entrepreneurship,
occupational therapy,
University of Arkansas Community College at Morrilton to study business,
industrial mechanics,
nursing,
University of Arkansas to study nursing,
University of Arkansas at Little Rock to study civil engineering and construction management,
University of Texas at Dallas majoring in business.
Imagine Paul Mitchell to study aesthetics and cosmetology.
Little Rock School of Dental Assisting to study dental assisting.
Undecided, but studying pre-law.
Studying engineering.
Hi guys. Hi, can everyone please raise a glass?
I'm out of glass.
Raise our,
yeah.
Double cup.
Guys, we're here for the best. 2018.
Yeah!
Oh, that was great. That was scary.
Tradition.
That's all we have for this special episode. But as always, we want to wish a happy birthday to everyone who celebrated this past week.
For our last time,
stay connected.
Good.
That was not 1, 2, 3.
Nope. Yeah, I know.
That was 0.5.
All right.